These two does affect the sensitivity of the results.
Which two?
If we have heater with the transducer separately, does this affect the sensitivity finally?
Look, there are two different approaches, but if you are dealing, for instance, with your tin dioxide nanoplatelets, if you will change temperature in both cases in a such a way that this is the same, for instance, 350 degrees centigrade, you should get the same sensitivity. The same. Why should it be different? The same. Because it's the same operational temperature. The same operational temperature. There's no reason for any difference between these two results. That's right? Please, questions. I love questions. Questions are good.
Okay, I have a question. When you mention those three structures, you mentioned that they are three structures more used.
Widely used, yes. Let's come back.
Are you talking about commercial structures or about research? Or?
Three of them are widely used. From research point of view, it's irrelevant which one are you using. Yeah? It's not like this that I can say this one is preferable. All of them are good, are equally good. All of them are equally good.
And those three are commercially available?
Good question, good question, very good question. You can buy them. Yes, you can buy them.
But
usually the situation is like with the gas, like the multi-channel gas testing system. Usually most of the people around the world are designing homemade. Yeah, multi-channel gas system. You did the same, we did it ourselves, yeah? There are some companies in Europe, you can buy multi-channel gas calibration system. Similar story with conductometric transducers. There are some companies, you can buy them, but most of the people are fabricating them themselves. Most of the people. And I tell you something, it's better way to spend your money than to buy. Mm-hmm. I have a proposal to buy some substrates for you. Don't buy conductometric transistors. We are not buying. We are not buying. However, it's better to collaborate. For instance, when I need special conductometric substrates, very special, with operational temperature up to 800 degrees centigrade, I'm collaborating with Professor Moss in Nuremberg, Germany. And last IMCS we presented two joint papers because we use his transducers. So it's better to collaborate internationally with other people. That's right? We are not very rich. We are poor. Like a church mouse. Church mouse is very poor. University people are poor. This is the reality. Please, other questions. Everything should be. Discussions are always good. You know, different topics, subjects. If there is any question mark in your mind, please ask me. Because
I was wondering which are the best materials to make transducers for measuring the traces of heavy
metals. Seems to be counting again on your sense of humor that heavy metals are your obsession.
Yes. Yes, of course, because this they're very interesting.
Very interesting.
Contamination.
But in gas or liquid media?
Okay, in gas, I believe we can use one of these structures, one of these materials you are telling us.
Refresh my mind, please.
Cadmium.
It's the cadmium. Cadmium is present in the air which we are breathing. Because I know for sure that liquid media is ubiquitous everywhere.
Yes.
But in gas?
In gas sometimes, when they smoke, I believe they also contaminate you with cadmium.
Okay.
You are beside a person who's smoking too. Mm-hmm. Even you are not a smoker, yeah. You are
Passive smoker.
Also you are contaminated.
Next question, supported question. Tell me, do you know any papers regarding the carbon measurements in gas media?
No, most of the time is in liquid.
In liquid.
Such as water, polluted water.
Because I've never seen any paper regarding carbon measurements in the gas media.
Yes. Yeah, it's not a common, how can I say, application they're looking for, but I believe it's because it's difficult to perform or fabricate the sensor because I haven't found in literature about sensing gases.
Okay, I will give you a hint.
Again for the main
point. Any questions? No? I will give you a hint. In an ordinary metal insulator heat ever transistor, as everybody knows, is this this is the sandwich structure, yeah? Silicon substrate, silicon dioxide, metal gate, two regions of source and drain, perpendicular electrical field, and the flow of current between source and drain is controlled. What some people are doing, they are designing so-called suspended gate heat effect transistor. The structure is different. In this case, you have the same silicon substrate, yeah? You have an air gap. You have an insulator, proper insulator, and metal gate on the top. And the rest, source and drain, as before. What some people are doing, because in order to sense cadmium, you need a selective membrane.
Okay.
I don't know which one could be honestly speaking. I don't know. But as I said, there is an American scientist who spends all his life developing membranes.
Okay.
He knows.
Who is this guy?
That's a good point. I've forgotten his name.
Okay.
End of the week. I've forgotten his name. But I am sure that in the chemistry literature, you can find out cadmium membranes operating in liquid media. That's right.
Okay.
So this cadmium membrane from liquid you can adapt for gas. So now, if you deposit this. I can give you a contacts in Europe, people who are working on this, not on cadmium, but a suspended gate heat effect transistor.
Okay.
There is a, the sandwich will be like this, silicon substrate, air gap, your membrane deposited in an air gap region, membrane which selectively senses cadmium present in a cigarette smoke, yeah? Later you will put an insulator, metal gate, and that's it. Electrical characteristic of this device are they have the same shape like for ordinary MESPET. If you take the, again, this is a terminology. If you will take the so-called transfer characteristic, because electronic people call it transfer characteristic. Transfer characteristic for ordinary MESPET is like this. Drain current, ID, versus gate cells voltage. That's right? This is a transfer characteristic. Yeah? If, speculating loudly, what will happen from MESPET physics point of view? In this case, due to the interaction of cadmium molecules with this selective membrane, work function will change. Work function will change. And as a result, this characteristic will shift. It will shift in one or other direction. It will shift. This is with cadmium, CD. So again, if you will employ constant current mode of operation, constant drain current mode of operation, this is your output signal, delta VGS. This is, I'm only speculating loudly. That's what I will do, knowing a little bit, because I'm not familiar with cadmium sensors operating in gas media. But I will take this approach. So this is your transfer characteristic in this case. Cadmium concentration, voltage as an output signal. Using suspended gate field effect transistor. That could be a solution to this. That could be a solution to this, I believe. But I was never, honestly speaking, interested on sensing cadmium in a gas media. So I never seen a paper in literature regarding this issue. But it's a good idea to jump into Google and put few keywords. Maybe this is already done.
Selected membranes for cadmium first. Correct.
This is the first step. Correct. Very correct.
I've been looking for sensors, but maybe they haven't been
performed. Yeah, in gas media.
For this application.
In gas media, yeah.
It's a clue to start with membranes. Correct. Even though they already exist.
They already existing for liquid media, I'm absolutely sure.
But it's easy because if you find a membrane that detects the cadmium or is sensible to cadmium.
Say it again, please.
It's easy. If I find a membrane that detects the cadmium in liquid, I can transform the.
You can
cadmium,
adapt this to gas media, you can try. Yeah? But I tell you something. I tell you something very funny story. I recollect this now. When I work in the US, some people reported that they are able to sense antigen or antibodies
concentration in a liquid, in a gas media, with a high, in an environment with high relative humidity. For instance, in a tropical climate. At the first glance, it could have a sense. And what happened? I remember during this time I traveled to Toronto, because we had a collaboration with Toronto University, and I spoke to one of the professors, and he was furious. Why? Because, you know, the antibody-antigen interaction occurs in a liquid media. Inside our body, this is liquid media, not a gas media. So he told me that he himself, as well as several researchers, his colleagues around the world, they were trying to repeat these results obtained, reported in this paper. They spent a couple of months, they were not successful. So there were two options. One option was that the guy who reported this made mistake, presenting some false results. Or second option was that he was so smart that he did not disclose everything in his paper.
It's normal.
Yeah, because some people are doing this. They are trying to protect their patent rights. They are publishing paper in a such a way that you are not able to repeat, which is dishonest. Because if you decided to report, you have to be honest. You are reporting this to the whole scientific community around the world. People should gain from your knowledge. However, so until now, nobody repeated this. But the reason why I'm telling you this story is that it could be like this, that the membrane operating in a liquid media will not operate in a gas media. Again, I'm speculating loudly. I'm curious, but it is very likely that if you will be successful, you will be the first in the world. I am attending international congresses through all my life, and I don't remember that anybody presented this.
No, it's good that you tell me that, because I was looking for, I think that doesn't exist.
That's
but
right.
I might think, well, we can, my boss, I mean, can measure some, the cadmium in molecules, instead of the, not before breathing it, but when person is contaminated. Or,
Everything is possible. I'm always saying that everything is possible in life. Everything. But sometimes you have to pay very high price. So some people are not taking challenge because they understand the price will be very high. But challenge is good for blood circulation. That's right.
Yes.
It's good. Also for brain activity, challenge is good, always good. Look, thanks for your question, but general, because I'm here, if you have any sensing problems, ideas, you want to discuss, I'm easy person. You can approach me, I will commit some time, we can discuss, I can advise, I can debate with you, it's a pleasure for me. Okay? So please interact with me. Okay? Thank you very much for your attendance, and see you on Monday morning. So I should come to your office at 2 o'clock or 1 o'clock.